when the computer evaluates an expression, every time you do an operation with floating point numbers, you can think of this as if the exact number is actually computed, but then the result needs to be stored as a temporary value, intermediate value. Let's examine the addition of two floating point numbers. And I stress we're working with floating point numbers, and therefore they're already stored in the computer. When we add those two floating point numbers, we may end up creating a real value that is not a floating point number, and therefore the result has to be stored, and that then incurs an error, namely epsilon, where the absolute value of epsilon is bounded by the machine epsilon. Okay? And for every one of our fundamental operations, addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division, the exact same thing happened. It's as if you computed the exact result, but then had to store the final result. Now, what's important to realize is that every time you do an addition, a subtraction, etc., the epsilon that you incur may be slightly different. Its value is bounded by the same machine epsilon, but the value that you actually incur may be slightly different. So, in this setting, what we really should do is emphasize that this epsilon may be different from this epsilon, may be different from this epsilon, may be different from that epsilon. And if we perform multiple additions in an operation, for example, then each of the epsilons that you run into may actually be a slightly different value, all of them bounded by the machine epsilon.